Hello to everybody. Now we have to discuss about Dirichlet's conditions for Fourier series. Recapitulation: definition of periodic functions, definition of Fourier series, derivation of Fourier coefficients a0, an, bn. So these are learning objectives. These are session outcomes. Prerequisites for Dirichlet's conditions: trigonometry, summation notation, complex number manipulation, linear algebra. Dirichlet's conditions. Trigonometric Fourier series. Consider a real valued function f of x which obeys the following conditions known as Dirichlet's conditions. The first one is f of x is defined in an interval c, c plus 2l, periodic with period 2l, finite and single value. Second condition is f of x is continuous or has only a finite number of simple discontinuous in the interval c, c plus 2l. Third one, f of x has at the most a finite number of maxima and minima also in the interval c, c plus 2l. Also, so let a0 is equal to 1 by l integration of c to c plus 2l f of x dx, and an is 1 by l integration of c to c plus 2l f of x cos n pi by l in x into dx. Here n is 1, 2, 3 up to infinity, and bn is equal to 1 by l integration of c to c plus 2l f of x sin of n pi by l into x dx. Then the infinite series a0 by 2 plus summation n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos n pi x by l plus summation n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi by l into x. This is called Fourier series for the function f of x in the interval c, c plus 2l. Here a0, a1, an and b0, b1, bn are Fourier coefficients of f of x. The formula 1, 2 and 3 are known as Euler's formulas. Session summary: Dirichlet's conditions and Fourier series. Multiple choice questions. First one, how many Dirichlet's conditions are there? Answer is C, 3. Second one, what are the Dirichlet's conditions? Answer is B, conditions required for Fourier series to converge if continuous. Third one, what is the first Dirichlet's condition? Answer is A, over any period signal x of t must be integrable. Fourth one, is Dirichlet's condition possible in case of discrete signals? Answer is B, false. Fifth one, what is the second Dirichlet's condition? Answer is A, if any finite interval x of t is of bounded variation. These are the reference books. Thank you, one and all.